Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate how to send HTTP request messages from a message flow running in ACE to a backend web service which is secured using Basic Auth. So in ACE version 12.0.11, a new policy type has been provided called HTTP request. And this can be used with the HTTP request node. This is easier to use than the security profile, and the policy can be used to reference a credential in a vault if you're using Basic Auth or if you're using API key credentials. The HTTP credential type can be dynamically updated in a vault, and the new credential is used by message flow without needing a restart of a flow or the integration server. So I'm going to use the same scenario as I did when I previously showed how to use Basic Auth with the HTTP request node. But instead of using a security profile, I'm going to use a HTTP request policy. I have a backend integration server, and that is secured using Basic Auth. I'm going to create a flow and a policy, and they will be deployed to a frontend integration server. I will create a credential in a vault, which is in the front-end integration server as well. And I will show you how the HTTP request node can use the policy to then access the back-end web service. So I'm going to show this from scratch so that you can follow along. First of all, I'm going to open some command consoles. And I'm going to create the integration servers. So let's create a brand new directory where I will create the work directories for the integration servers. So let's create a directory for this demo. I'll then cd into it. And let's create the front end work directory. And let's create the backend work directory. I'm going to configure the backend integration server so that it is going to use Basic Auth for admin security. So I just need to uncomment this field and set it to true. And it's going to use the default port, which is 7600. So I'll just create a user ID and password for the integration server. So I'm using the MQSI web user admin command to create it. I have a user ID, admin, and a password, which is password 1. And now I can start the backend integration server. So the integration server has started and it has admin security enabled. I can check that it is enabled by bringing the web UI up, and I can see that it's asking for user ID and password. So if I enter admin and the password, I can log in. Okay. So that is the backend integration server. Let's now create the vault for the front-end integration server. I'm going to create the vault using the MQSI vault command, and I'm using a vault key which has a value my vault key. And now I'm going to create the credential so that the flow can access the backend web service. I'm going to create a credential type HTTP, and I'm specifying the ID admin and the password, password 1. Okay, so the credential has been added, and now let's start creating the policy and the flow. So let's start with creating the policy. So I'll create a policy project to call it Basic Auth PP. And I'm going to create a policy. I'm going to call it Basic Auth policy. And I'm going to use the new HTTP request policy type. and I'm going to specify the credential name, which is Basic Auth Cred, in the policy. And so now the policy is referencing the credential. Okay, so now let's create the message flow. So first I'll create the application, Basic Auth Demo, and create a flow, Basic Auth. And I'm just going to use simple HTTP nodes, so an HTTP input node to drive the flow, an HTTP request node to send a request to the backend, and then an HTTP reply node to send a reply. I'm also going to wire up the error terminal to another HTTP reply node so we can see errors easily. So let's configure the nodes. I need to specify path suffix for the input node. Demo there. And for the HTTP request node, I need to specify the URL it will be accessing. So it is the API v2 URL. I will be using a get method. And now I need to simply reference the policy from the HTTP request node. So I can go to the policy tab. There is a new policy node attribute here. I can click the browse button and select the policy from the policy project. So now the node is referencing the policy, which in turn is referencing the credential. Let's start the integration server. So I'm going to start the front-end integration server with a port of 7601. So the server has started, and now I'm going to connect to the integration server. Localhost and 7601. And now I'm going to deploy the policy project. So that is deployed. I will now use the flow exerciser to send a message to the flow, which will cause the flow to be deployed. So the flow is deployed now. And if I send a message to the flow, it could just be a blank message. I can see that I've received data back from the API v2 API. And that is using Basic Auth. And I can see that it was sent to the API v2. Let's now change the password for the backend web service and then try to send a message through, and we should see it fail. So let's stop the backend server. So stop the backend integration server. And I'm going to change the password of the user ID from password 1 to password 2. So the new password is now password 2. And now I'm going to start the backend integration server again. So now, if I send another message through the flow, this time I'm getting a 401 error. So it's telling me that it can't send the HTTP request to the backend because an invalid password, because currently this flow is using this credential and this credential is using password 1, but I have of course updated it to password 2. I'm now going to show that I can update for a credential so that it is now password 2. So I'm going to use MQSI credentials to update the password. So that's been updated. And if I now send a message through again, this time it's worked. So you can see that I haven't needed to restart the flow. I haven't needed to restart the integration server. It has just picked up the change to the credential automatically. In this video, I've shown how to use an HTTP request node using an HTTP request policy to send request messages to a backend web service using Basic Auth. to do this, I had to do three steps. I had to create the user ID and password for the HTTP credential in the vault. I created an HTTP request policy, which referenced the credential. And then I specified the HTTP request policy on the HTTP request node. Then that allowed the flow to use a credential.